का निनारा कर जो विचार धुररी बूंद किया विस्तारा तीन देवन किया प्रगाश अधुर धूण पावन दल पानी फूटा इंड जना थर प्या है आकाश बेला बंदिया अड़ा अमावसा कर परगा स्वंत्रा गुवंत्रा लिथमा पार्वती नेम लिया निरंजन एनाथ
Padmashree Komal Kothari, as a folklorist and ethnomusicologist, has made a name in international academia. His contribution in form of introducing folk music of Rajasthan all over the world has been well recognized. There is continuous chain of programs abroad of genuine performers from desert zone of Rajasthan. Here, in presence of workshop participants, he talks about folk narratives. A study of folk narratives can have many, many different directions. One could study the problem of folk motives or study tale types to internationally put up the narrative into a particular socket. One should choose one direction to work. One works in the field of folk narratives to gather interesting stories, to write and publish them. Another decides folk tales are very interesting lessons in our jobs as teachers. Yet another wants to collect stories and see who tells the story, why and for whom, as well as the type of social significance or social message it contains.
So whatever that I am talking to you about folk narratives, I am talking what came in my way when we entered into the world of folk narratives. The first thing was important to me, who tells the story? Who is the teller of the tale? Now in Rajasthan, you can in your own region see differently as this particular genre exists in your society, but in Rajasthan, the different type of narratives I have tried to list it out with whom we worked when we collected the stories. First, I begin with professional storytellers. Professional storytellers means that he expects some type of remuneration, he expects some type of fee for him, and he is professionally engaged in it. Now this definition is little, I'll have to shift from this definition. We have a whole class of people who are known as Bhat, genealogists. The role of the genealogist is to keep track of your family line, specifically male line. My son, his son, his son, his son, his son, his son. Now there are two types of the Bhats, which we call it Mukhbancha Bhat and Pothi Bancha Bhat. Mukhbancha Bhat keeps the genealogy orally. He doesn't write. He doesn't keep record in writing. The other is Pothi Bancha Bhat. He keeps a bahi, a record, where he writes the name. Now for this purpose, each family has to pay them. Without paying the money, the name will not be entered in his bahi, nor will be entered into his memory. So these are the two types of Bhats. The practice in Rajasthan is that practically every third year, the Bhats comes to your family, and within 3 years, whatever newborn children are there, they take the names in their bahis and go. Usually people feel that this type of genealogy were kept only for the kings and jagirdars or feudal lords or something like that. that is not true. Any society in any group in Rajasthan which claims a caste status has to have a genealogist. And at the moment, this institution of keeping the genealogy like this is very strong in the so-called low caste groups. Most of the art forms also are alive today is because of this particular system which somehow or other kept many traditions alive for us and in a vigorous form. Now these bhats, when they come, they stay for 2-3 days in your family or in the village from the same caste group, will go from place to place, and evenings they will be telling stories. This is actually a full performance. He will sit at a particular place. There will be audience before him, men and women both. And he will highly ornament his speech. He would have a lot of formulas in it where he describes a king. Then is a large body of material which will come, how the king looked, how he rode in the horse, and what happened to him and not happened to him, and then his ornaments and long list of ornaments, and when it will describe the beauty of the queen or beauty of the heroine, then a formal thing will appear. She looked like this, looked like this, like that. But whenever this a reference to beauty would come, that some material, physical material, will be put up there also. So for the horses, for elements, for camels, for drinking, all these type of things will appear in these stories, and they are highly ornamented, told in a very, very literary way. This is the tradition of the Bhat. Now, there is another group, as I told you, Mukhvancha Bhat. Now, these people are only available with the low caste groups. We have recordings of 3-4 people, and then we had chance to listen to a lot of this type of Mukhvancha Bhat, the oral genealogist, and one can see a sort of a continuity between the say organization of Puranas and this type of oral storytelling. So Puranas have 5 chapters. Sarg, Pratisarg, one more I'm forgetting, Manvantar and Pralaya. And this is exactly the format of this oral story, oral genealogist, when they tell this story, all these things appear. As I tell you, because these people tell the stories about low caste people, you know, they problem is that no society or no group can survive without its own mythology. That we will say times and again. Our problem while working was the low caste people, the way they live in the society, then what have they with them? And that was in search of that material, we arrived at the institution of Mukhvancha Bhat, or this oral genealogist. And then he was talking. So one of the stories which, when they tell the genealogy, they tell hundreds of stories. I'll tell you one of the stories which came from the Mukhvancha Bhat. It was about a tribe in Mewar region. They are known as a Roth. It's a very small group. And it was accidentally that we were passing through there, and the acrobatic group was reciting the genealogy of that particular group. There was a crowd of about 400-500 people, men and women both, and he was telling this story. And the story which he told was something like this. there was a person who was named Punya. Before that, there was no agriculture. Nobody knew what the agriculture is. It was for the first time that the Punya sowed the seeds of maize, corn. And his field turned out to be really great. When he was to harvest his crop, sun and moon came. And they said that, Punya, you have grown something, it's beautiful. But without us, could you have done your agriculture? So Punya says, no, I would not have been able to do without you. Sun and moon, and without whom to do agriculture, impossible. So he said, that give our share too. So he said, the whole field belongs to you. Take it. They moved in the field, and they looked at the top of the corn plant, which has a beautiful flower. They had also not seen agriculture any time. They said, the upper part belongs to us, and the lower part belongs to you. Punya said, all right. So the sun and moon got nothing, and the Punya got whole corn crop. The corn grows on the middle part of it. Next year, Punya shifted to other cultivation, and he sowed sorghum, jawar. Again, sun and moon came and said, you take the top and middle, we will keep it. Again, Punya had all the grain. Sun and moon had no grain. When he finished this part of the thing, he played drum very vigorously, which they do. And then he said, can you tell me who is this Surya and Chandra? Who is this sun and moon? And the people sitting there, 400 people, with one voice said, they are Chandravanshi and Suryavanshi. Who are Chandravanshi and Suryavanshi? The rulers of that place. Like that, they have, in our about 12 hours of recording, we have such tales. If the high caste people listen to their stories, they will be angry. They will be unhappy. So one way or other, a type of a big narrative lore of very important life aspect of a lot of people is available at this point. But in this, both the cases, as I tell you, we call them professional storytellers. They prepare themselves for it. The particular way of telling the story is transmitted to them. They learn it and they tell the story. So this is, say, one group of the professional storytellers. There is another group which is a known professional storyteller. But this we have found in Rajasthan, that most of that working period, which comes in the night, they have to work for the whole night, and they have a lot of time in between. And when the people gather together, he tells the story to pass the time. Now, everybody cannot tell this story. There are few people in the villages who expertise in telling this story, and they tell this story. They are always long lays, story lasting for 1 hour or 2 hours, something like that, and they tell this story. Similarly, in the villages, when people are sitting and doing nothing and waiting for something or other, in that case, the people will ask the storyteller from that place to tell a story, and he will tell the story. Now, these are very, very compact stories. So this, again, but this storyteller also tells in a little heightened speech, little theatrically also, and it is also a sort of a organized performing situation.
In our next part, Padmashri Komal Kothari will continue his talk on common stories, proverbial tales and women's narratives which are very known to all in rural Rajasthan.
ਦੀਪ ਕਾਡੀਆ ਜੰਮੂ ਦੀਪ ਸਾਲਮ ਦੀਪ ਕਣਨ ਦੀਪ ਕਿਰਤ ਦੀਪ ਸੰਕ ਦੀਪ ਪੁਸ਼ਪ ਦੀਪ ਦਾਮੋ ਦੋ ਧਨ ਲਾਕਾ ਪੁਰਸ਼ ਦੋ ਪਰਵਾਣ ਸਾਲਮ ਦੀਪ ਲਖ ਚਾਰ ਅਸਲ ਦਾ ਕਿਰਤ ਬਣੀ ਦੇ ਕਿਰਤ ਸੋਲੇ ਲਾਖ ਸੰਕ ਦੋ ਤੀਸ ਬਕਾਣ ਪੁਸ਼ਪ ਪੈਂਸਠ ਲਾਖ ਹਨ ਦੁਗਮ ਦੁਗਮ ਕਰਦਾਣੀ ਜਗਨਨਾਥ ਬੇਰਾਟਰੂ ਤੋ ਹਰੀ ਅਵਤਾਰ ਬਖਾਣੀ ਸਾਧ ਦੀਪਾਮ ਸਾਧ ਸਮੁੰਦਰ ਆ ਕਾਡੀਆ ਖੀਰ ਸਮੁੰਦਰ ਦੁੱਧ ਸਮੁੰਦਰ ਗ੍ਰਿਤ ਸਮੁੰਦਰ ਅਰਧਰ ਸਮੁੰਦਰ ਆਪ ਪਰਿਵਾਰ ਇਮਰਤ ਸਮੁੰਦਰ ਅਰਧਿਮ ਆਪ ਪਰਿਵਾਰ ਖਾਰਾ ਐ ਸਮੁੰਦਰ ਐਸਾ ਸਾ